Grab the yarn and start with a slip knot. For the base of the purse, make 29 chains. Chain 3, double crochet on the third chain from the hook. Continue on making double crochet on every stitch. Now that we have one row, we're going to make another row of single crochet. Chain 1, turn your work. Single crochet on every stitch. 2 stitches, I made 2 double crochet. So after the front post DC row, we're going to make another row of single crochet. Chain 1, turn your work, single crochet on the next stitch. Continue on making single crochet on every stitch until you reach the end of the row. So after the single crochet, we're going to repeat the front post DC row. Chain 2, turn your work, double crochet on the next stitch, and then make a front post DC from the previous row. Double crochet on the next stitch, and then repeat front post DC. After this, you're going to make a double crochet on the next stitch. And you're going to repeat this until there's 2 stitches left. On the last 2 stitches, make 2 double crochet. Basically, you're going to repeat the single crochet row and the front post DC row until you are satisfied with the height of your purse. So I made a total of 9 rows. After that, we're going to make a single crochet all around. Chain 1, turn your work, make 1 single crochet per space. Also, don't forget to put your stitch marker on the chain 1 to determine the corner of your purse. Continue on making single crochet, chain 1 at the corner. Make 1 single crochet per stitch and then chain 1 again at the corner. And then single crochet on each space and then chain 1 at the corner. Also, don't forget to place your stitch markers. So at this corner, chain 1, single crochet on the next stitch, place your stitch marker, continue on making single crochet on each stitch. And when you reach the last stitch, make a slip knot, then cut the yarn. This will be the front part and you will repeat the same row you made for the back part. So here's the back part and don't proceed on making the single crochet on each side for the back part, because we're going to make that later. So at the back part, you're going to need 2 more rows of front post DC. After the 2 rows of front post DC, we're going to start with the decrease. Chain 1, turn your work, single crochet on the first stitch, and then we're going to proceed with the decrease. First, you'll need to find the front loop of the next stitch, then another front loop, and then make a single crochet. So that's how we're going to make our decrease. Proceed on making single crochet on each stitch until there's 3 stitches left. using the front loops. Make one single crochet on the last stitch. So that's how we're going to make the decrease row. After the decrease row, chain 2. Repeat the same procedure for the front post DC. Double crochet on the next stitch. And then make a front post DC. You're going to repeat the double crochet and front post DC until you reach the end of the row. As you can see, the sides of the back part is starting to slant or in triangular form. After the front post DC, again, we're going to repeat the decreased row. Chain 1, turn your work, single crochet on the next stitch. Make a decrease, find the 2 loops. And then proceed on making a single crochet using the 2 loops. Single crochet on every stitch until there's 3 stitches left. Basically, you're just going to repeat the decrease row and the front post row 4-5 times alternately. So here's our back part, much longer than the front part. Chain 1, single crochet all around, just like what we did on the front part. And don't forget to place stitch markers on the corners. Continue on making single crochet until you reach the top right corner. After the single crochet all around, find the middle stitch and then place the stitch marker. This will serve as a guide so you will know where you're going to put the button. So the next step will depend on the size of your button. So I made enough space for the button and chain 12. Again, as I said, this will depend on the size of your button. Since the button that I made is big, I made 12 chains. And then single crochet on the other side. When you do this part, make sure that the button will fit on the chains that you made. continue on making single crochet on every stitch. Make a slip knot and then cut the yarn. Don't forget to insert or hide the excess yarns. So this is my way on how to hide, and you can do whatever you want just to make your project look clean. So the next step is that we're going to attach the front and back part together using single crochet. So before we start, make sure to arrange the front and back part like this. The inner part should be outside and the part with texture should be inside. To start, find the corner and then place your yarn. And then make a knot. Make single crochet on every stitch. So the back part and front part will be attached by continuing on making single crochet. And then make a slip knot when you reach that part, then cut the yarn. So in this part, you're just going to make a single crochet on every stitch. So here's the velvet purse we look like. To finish the velvet purse, you're just going to need to sew the button. And if you want it to be a sling bag, we'll need to attach the straps. First, attach the yarn at the side part. And then make chains depending on how long you want it to be. Before you attach it, make sure that it's not twisted. After that, attach the yarn using a slip knot. And now, to make the strand more thicker, turn your work, double crochet on the first stitch of the strap. Chain one, skip one stitch, and then double crochet on the next stitch. Again, chain one, skip one stitch, double crochet on the next stitch. You will repeat these steps until you reach the last stitch of the strap. And then at the end, secure it with a slip knot.